On the handoff, it's Geis. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. Starting to feel a little to me like the air is coming out of the balloon, so to speak, defensively.
They're taking their will from them right now. That's what they're doing. Whatever they want to call, it's working. They're handling things up front, and it's not just the offensive line. It's everyone. You're seeing the guys on the perimeter blocking down.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Paul Richardson, his second touchdown of the night, and the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it, tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
Hopkins with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And three interceptions in this game, and I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, 21, 21. But number four is kind of, oh, you're 12. Like, oh man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. A good pickup there, a 22. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. 21. On first down, Garoppolo. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. To throw is Garoppolo. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 38, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead, and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch-counterpunch, hasn't it, all throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. That's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Washington. Paul Richardson, 63 yards. And the Redskins find a way to stretch their lead.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. Extra point good by Hopkins, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. And And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Ball going deep here for Taylor. And my goodness, another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Back to the air. Smith on second down. Here's a screen to Powell. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. And give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The Redskins on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now Smith. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20 and down to the 16-yard line. His 5th catch tonight, and it's good for a first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Now a first down throw. It's Smith. This is caught. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Jordan Reed, a beast in the red zone with his 2nd touchdown of the game. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. Hopkins with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. A good pickup there, a 22.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post-route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it. And he got it. Garoppolo, a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. 1st and 10. Garoppolo. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. 2 nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Toss play to McKinnon. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this.
throw on second down. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Play action, Garoppolo. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. Preston Smith in there to get him for a loss of nine, and that'll lead to fourth down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Garoppolo, got to have this one. And now here is another interception. And it's Ha-Ha Clinton Dix with a pick. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. What a nightmarish game he's having now. Six interceptions that he has thrown.
Absolutely unbelievable, isn't it? Hard to believe we're watching this and have seen it. But it just tells you about the game of football. It giveth and it taketh away.
Yeah, the guys, though, that have thrown six interceptions in a game, the likes of Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, I think Joe Namath, he did it three times. Throwing now, Smith. He's going to air one out. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
Geis found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
The Redskins on third down. They've hit two for four thus far. This will be third and five.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
They'll run it now out of the gun. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's fourth down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here's Tressway now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. 11. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do.
And my goodness, another interception. Monte Nicholson picks it. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, Oski, everyone turned to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
Smith going to throw it. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
Well, I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want want to, because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even bother running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you're going to go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what they do here. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
Run up the money, I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. I'm really just running for money, I'm love flow, Joe chasing the check. I'm really gonna run up the money, I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed. Car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed.
Bigger the bag, bigger the beef, bigger the problem, bigger the be one in the all in the same. Broke at the end of the month, flow Joe, kill Mo, run it up, keep Mo clean, never let them touch, fits like temper tantrums, girl, come back that up, all in the club, and bring out your girlfriends, girl, hopping up about a Pearl 6, Louis speed bag glued to her wrist, she was getting paid, she ain't think a thing, but she was thinking slay, we blade thicker than a snigger bay, talking about she don't come with no baggage, y'all in her bag, I probably should.
I'm really just running for money, I'm love flow, Joe chasing a check, I'm really gonna run up the money, I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best, car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed, car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed, I'm really just running for money, I'm love flow, Joe chasing a check, I'm really gonna run up the money, I'm Carl Lewis, really running the best, car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed, car moving through these hoovers, I maneuver with the bag, baby, never feeling stressed.
If the squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah. Hey. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, Dodge, Range, drops. Big bag plays on FaceTime.
Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, dodge, rain drops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Cross move quick like AI. Big red like waist high. I don't do lanes. Lil' bitch, watch y'all like 2 Chainz. I done swerved in a new lane. Bang at the crit, do things. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah, no it ain't, no it. They ain't talking cash, so I did the race. NASCAR with the pace, Fiji water on the chain. You know love where I'm from. When I'm on a beat, I make it thump. I need that bread like every crumb. Came up from nothing, made a sum. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad, same squad, same squad. Drop top, coupe, dodge, raindrops. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Ay, 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 ay.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. For Nick Chubb. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
And now Mayfield on the bootleg. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Jarvis Landry, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
So trouble already here on their opening drive. This is third
over,
and nine.
Over. Here we go now.
Mayfield off the play fake. And he's taken down here by the Saints. These strong safeties, some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in him on that play emerged.
So on fourth down, Britton Colquitt on the punt. fielded at about the 28. Nice move by Lewis. A great blocking nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here, first and 10. First down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Looking for Gannon. It's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue landed.
They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Von Bell up to make the tackle.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Mayfield now on second down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Marcus Williams. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
The good old cover three defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone.
For the first time with Alvin Kamara. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Second down, here's Breeze. And that's going to be incomplete. Ben Watson was the intended target. Third down here.
Let's give some credit to the defensive guys on that play. Able to bat that one away. Sure looked like they were trying to hit the corner route.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Gun. It's Breeze. That's complete to Meredith. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
A first opportunity upcoming in the red zone for the Saints. They've got a first and goal to go at the seven. Here's Breeze to throw. Got a man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. Michael Thomas from 6 yards away. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Will Lutz on for the point after. Lutz good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Browns offense trotting back onto the field. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find the matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
That is caught by the former Gator, Antonio Callaway. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
On first down, they'll run to Chubb. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Set! 3-19! 3-19!
Mayfield down. Screen play, Johnson. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
A first down carry here for Johnson. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Demario Davis.
Offensively, when you see cover two, the thought has to go through the quarterback's head. Drive the football when making throws. It's not just the deep guys covering. It's the guys underneath you have to be careful of. Drive your throw. Otherwise, you see what results? Interceptions.
Right. So after the INT, it's Breeze. Wide open receiver complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. That one good for 17 yards. And now they've got it first and goal.
There's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
It's second and goal, but now all the way back at the 14.
Ready. You ready?
Shotgun now for Breeze. And it's caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. Now, definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dial something up now, third and 10. Kamara, and he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. A great effort there, taking it in from a yard out, and the Saints add on to their lead. Lutz to try to add the PAT. Lutz with the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Now the Browns offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Oh, and now he pulls him over. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
First play of the drive. Excellent run. Just sets up wash, rinse, repeat. Another first down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Hey. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. Handoff comes to Chubb. And unable to get downhill there, so he'll take this up to about the 37. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Mayfield throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
On third down, it's Nick Chubb. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves them looking at a fourth down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they've bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Losing a yard or two. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape.
Ready? You ready?
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And now running right through it. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
Here we go, here we go. Ready? You ready? 11.
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Over the middle, that's caught by Meredith. Touchdown, New Orleans! Cameron Meredith, 33 yards. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Lutz will look to add the extra point. Lutz good on the extra point, and that makes the score 21 to zip. Lutz now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down 3 scores. A 3-and-out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3.
All right, here we go. Blue 90! Blue 90!
Mayfield on play action. He'll rifle this one deep right side, and that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. He was looking to get it to Jarvis Landry that time. And it's 3rd and short.
All right, here we go.
They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And an alley to run. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Mayfield now from the 50. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. And the timeout comes in with 2 seconds remaining. So they can trot out the field goal unit for the try before we hit the lockers. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And his kick here is good. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them.
Ready. We're waiting.
Breeze to throw on second down. That's caught by Meredith right side. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Give him 30 yards there. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. This is Ingram on first and 10. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 10 more there and another first down. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
First down, Breeze. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And that'll bring up second down.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Hey, break it down, fellas. Break it down. Hey, ready? You ready?
Now Breeze on third down. And that is incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
On fourth down, off goes Drew Breeze, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. This is an easy one, 23-yarder. And Lutz puts this one through. And that will extend their lead even further. That drive took them inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold them to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there, because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. Here's the Browns now. They get set for their first possession of the third quarter. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get
it. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Well, they're in some hot water now. Watch after that body, sack. Body. It's second and 21.
Let's go! 3-19! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Pass!
They go play action. Mayfield. He's going to rifle one deep left side, and he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position, couldn't hold on, third down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Third and long for Mayfield. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down. Here's Britton Colquitt now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is fielded at the 27. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. So Breeze going to lead the Saints up here. First and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. Here's Breeze. He sets the fire deep. That's caught inside the 20. And that one results in 35 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Into the red zone, it's Breeze. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit, and it forced an incompletion.
Ready? My fault.
On second down, Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Saints add on to their lead. Lutz to try to add the PAT. Lutz with the extra point, and that'll increase their lead to 28. Lutz now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the Browns offense back onto the field. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
No gain on the play there. Second down. They tried to run it to the short side of the field. There just wasn't a whole lot of room to work with.
Yeah, it seems like things just kept getting strung out towards the sideline, and he kept looking for a spot to dive up into the gap. There just wasn't one, so that turned into nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
And no gain. Back now here live in New Orleans. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number four. Second down throw for Mayfield. And this is going to be incomplete. Try to get it to Landry there, and it'll bring up third down.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. They pitch it to Chubb. They'll have a first down past the 40. The 40. The 30. 10. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 73 yards. And the Browns make some inroads here on that deficit. And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
You can break out your calculator, partner, because his yards per carry went up
it's
significantly,
skyrocketed.
Right? Big-time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that will get him one closer. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Four down. Check. Ready. We're waiting.
Set. Now Breeze throwing on second down. Finds his man, Watson, over the middle. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Breeze now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10.
Under. Ready. We're waiting.
On the counter, here's Kamara. There he goes, left side. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A big play there, 50 yards. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. So another score there. Often you talk about the 3 phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a 4th phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the 4th quarter. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the 4th quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. The Browns on 3rd down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 4.
Over, over.
Mayfield to throw it. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
They start the drive on the ground, Kamara. And a good pickup there. He gets about 6 up to midfield. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Throwing now is Breeze. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
Well, that was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, 2nd and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the 1st down, and that's exactly what he did.
Ready, ready.
And now before this 1st down play, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their 1st. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10.
We got chips over here.
Ready. We waiting. 11, 11, 11, 11.
Check. 53's Mike. Check. 53's
Mike.
Breeze now on 1st down. And his throw is incomplete. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10.
Tight ends, Ringo. Tight ends on the Ringo. Tight ends on the Ringo.
Ready. Through 90.
Breeze is looking to throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. And to me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, go ahead and throw the ball, man. You got the big lead. You got the clock on your side. Obviously, they don't care much about the feelings of the other team, do they?
Well, I was going to say, you better run to the locker room pretty quick after this one.
Well, right now, maybe. They're just looking at it from the fantasy perspective. More points for everyone if they win big.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And they're going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, this game is definitely over, but we do know some people like to go ahead and continue to add to their score, don't we?
Yeah, I don't know that they need to add any more right now, though. I'm just starting to think about those dinner plans tonight, my friend.
Well, you and I will be thinking about dinner plans, but we also know that plenty of people are thinking, how can I get some more scores for my fantasy, forever other things? They're trying to figure that part out now.
By the way, last weekend we went sushi because that's what you wanted. We're going steak tonight.
I'm in.
All right. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
This quarterback now, five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10.
Three down.
Throwing. Mayfield. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time. That'll bring up second down.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Set, blue, landed.
On second down, Mayfield again. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
On third down, Mayfield. And that will be incomplete as well. Good coverage that time by Patrick Robinson.
Sometimes it's just not your day. Here's another failure right there on third down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Lucky 56. Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Desperation time. Mayfield on fourth down. And it is incomplete. The linebacker, DeMario Davis, got a hand in to break that one up. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Bree's going to throw here. Over the middle to Smith. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. And that one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Throwing on first down is Breeze. His throw caught at about the 5. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. And now we're going to get a timeout. Somewhat pointlessly called with 3 seconds to go in a game that's already been decided. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal.
Four down. Check.
Right. They come out here in the eye.
Check the backer. Let's go.
Now a play fake here on first down. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Demarius Randle. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much.
If the squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah. Hey. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Yeah.
Time to bring the bass.
Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big back plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad. Cross move quick like AI. Chain shine bright like daytime. Stack big bread like waist high. I don't do lanes. Lil' watch, I like 2 chains. I done swear. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big bag plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Yeah, no it ain't. They ain't talking cash, so I did the race. NASCAR with the pace, feed you water on the chain. You know love where I'm from. When I'm on a beat, I make it thump. I need that bread like every crumb. Came up from nothing, made a sum. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. I came up, who I was down with. You change up, stay far from around me. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big bag plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Same squad. Drop top coupe, Dodge Range drives. Big bag plays on FaceTime. Squad ain't with me, then it ain't right. Ay.
Have an all white rank. Couldn't hit if had ain't. Lanes can't call it and you lame. You had it and you lost it, all the shame. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got 2 cribs in 2 states, I be doing the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks.
Bye. Big bank, tight, little bank. Bye. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low buy. Big bank, tight, low buy.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Chopper counter, go yard bandana. Big, a lot of like Santa. Threw a birthday party in a phantom. Big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, no channel like acrylic. Yeah, but had cornrows. I can see you hang with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank take small. Bank account on some talk. Attitude on some. Bank roll on what it do, boo. He had to roll at five. And if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank take low bank. Bank. Big bank take low bank. Bank. Type of money you gon' need to sight. Type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay white. Type of money gon' let you, let you. Big bank, take low bank. Big bank, take low bank.
She said, what you gon' do if I leave? I said, I'ma do me. B-I-G, everything zoomed in. Big, big on me looking like I'm moving in. Got my foot in the door and we still here. Coins that'll pay your whole semester, but you gotta bet it in a Tesla.
Big bank take low bank, bank. Big bank take low bank, bank. Type of money.
Go as the Browns made their entrance. They are ready to do battle with the Kansas City Chiefs. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. This is Williams, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Ware takes the give from Mahomes. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Throwing now is Mahomes. He's going to float this over the middle deep, and this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Demaryius Randle, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
A first carry now for Nick Chubb. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
Now let's go! 3-19!
Chubb on the counter, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And this is going to be incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
And out come the Chiefs now. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you. A huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
They begin the drive with Williams. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. He had a great read there from his free safety position. And, Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser-focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing. And on that play, he obviously had no presence to feel like he's being pushed for a pass. And without that, that allowed him to get up to the line of scrimmage and hold him to no gain.
Now Mahomes throwing on second down. And he checks this one down to Williams. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down. So negative yardage, a loss of three on second down, and that leads to a tough third down call.
Flip, 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 flip. Z. Slow.
Now here's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And now the Browns coming out on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. Thanks to that last play, a little more room to operate. First and 10 at the 18.
Gun, gun! Gun, gun!
First down, Mayfield. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller. That he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down to hands of the wrong team.
They'll run now with Ware. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They come out here in the eye. To the 3 yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the second and the third level.
Now with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden as the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. Watkins alone on the left side. Play clock about to expire. Andy Reid notices it and takes a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Flush down right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Emmanuel Ogba in there to get him for a loss of five.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
Play clock about to expire. We get a whistle and a timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts and still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. Boy, you'd hate to squander this great field position. Here's third and goal. Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill from 8 yards out, and the Chiefs are in for six. Well, that's about as quick of a passing touchdown as you'll ever see right there.
Everyone has a section in their playbook called the quick game. That was a super quick game. Out of the hands of the thrower, bam, right to the receiver, successfully for a touchdown.
How in-depth is that quick game part of the playbook?
It's pretty in-depth because people want the ball in the hands of the quarterback into the playmaker's hands downfield as fast as possible. There are a lot of plays, a lot of options involved with that.
Butker now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Browns offense heading back out to take possession. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney. Now let's go. Green 39, Green 39.
They begin this drive with Chubb. And some room to work. Look at the dance and the juke. And all the way down to the 29. A big play that time out of Chubb. 46 yards. And you talk about great blocking up front. I don't think he was even touched, not a finger on him, until he was brought down to the ground.
I think we heard the whoosh as he went by, didn't we? Right through the gap. No one there, as you outlined. No one touched him at all. A free sprint into the secondary.
Yeah, that's what you call breaking free right there.
Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10.
Here we go now. Green 39, Green 39.
Mike, number 53.
Mike, 53. Mayfield. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Scrimmage and taken down. Emmanuel Ogba there on the stop. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. They stay on the ground this time. It's Williams. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of four.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The Chiefs on third down. Just one for three thus far. This will be third and six. Gun, it's Mahomes, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It is tough to complete passes against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle, and he gets this away. And look at this, this is a good one. And the Browns getting set to go. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination, but they find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game. Yeah.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. A give. This is Chubb. And he's taken down but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. To play here in the first half. More from Cleveland after this.
Here we go. Blue 90.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, the ball comes out the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Johnson was the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Second and 10 now from the 27. A second down throw for Mayfield. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first. Down throw from Mayfield. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10. Here's Mahomes. That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down. Throw on second down. They'll leave this for Ware. It'll be a pickup of just two, and that'll force upon him a third and 14.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On third and long, it's Mahomes. And able to find Conley. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. A former first-round pick there on the coverage.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Z, 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 Z.
snap coming at one, and it's Mahomes. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Seconds, all that remains for this first half as they come up first and 10. Following the interception, Mayfield. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now. He was trying to force it into his receiver, Landry, and it's second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
From the gun, Mayfield. He's going to look deep down the field. The guy's man, complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39.
Final play of the half, Mayfield. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And this is taken in at the 5. We have hit halftime. Still 2 more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up. And we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And they start the second half with Johnson. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Mayfield now on second down. Open receiver, that's David Njoku. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. A run for Nick Chubb. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass, but in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
They set up the screen to Chubb. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. Give him 6 on the screen, but now it's third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on 3rd and 1. A carry here for the big tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. 1st and 10. Chubb. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. It was Reggie Ragland who got him down.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Now a second down throw for Mayfield. And that is incomplete. He was looking for Landry that time, and that'll make it third down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, they really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Chris Jones coming in to drop him for a loss of eight, and it'll be fourth down. Fourth down, Mayfield. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Reggie Ragland, and he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific play, taking the ball away after it looked like they were starting a drive.
And now that shutout still standing. You know that's something those defensive guys hold a lot of pride on, too.
No doubt about it. They are excited about where they are in this game.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Now Mahomes. He's got Watkins on the out route. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Chiefs first down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Being chased out. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Myles Garrett able to run him down for a loss of a yard.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely. Going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10. Three,
I would expect three, to see
90,
some pressure here.
And we're back now here in Cleveland. The Chiefs on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10.
Left, 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 left. Z, 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 Z.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And he's going to drop this off to Williams. Complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It's a four-yard pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And the kick by Butker is good. And that will make our score 9-0. A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a two-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
On the return, Jabril Peppers. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and a little bit.
Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Landry. And he's taken down inside the 30. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another first down. This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and that'll make it second and short. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. And it's caught inside the 5. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another first down. Mayfield with it once more. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the completion. It's second and goal.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
They'll give it to Chubb. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
What a game this defense has played. They're pitching a shutout, so it'll be fun to watch down the stretch to see if their defensive coordinator continues to be as aggressive as he's been all game long.
This is third and goal, this Chiefs defense. They're giving it all they got. Throwing, Mayfield, and that is incomplete.
I know every offense wants to start their snaps closer to the goal line, but it's actually harder to throw the ball in those situations. You throw into that tight coverage, you see what happens. Hard to get the ball in there.
Not enough space there. Lucky maybe that it wasn't intercepted. And this one is right through. And they are on the board. It's now 9-3. All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3-and-out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. The field goal we just saw has this now at a one-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? Might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying to get done on offense.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. On second down, here's Mahomes. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Myles Garrett in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. To throw is Mahomes. Over the middle, complete. That's Sherman. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Here we go now.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. As they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Interesting, Mahomes wants to throw it. Dumps that off to Ware. A big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Now run it, man, out of the gun. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. On second down, Williams. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Give him two on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about 9 to go. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they stop it with 14 seconds to go in the game. The Chiefs on third down. 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 9. Again, it's Williams, and he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Well, Charles, the old saying, the old cliche, if you will, points at a premium. That certainly applied here, didn't it?
And that almost felt like opened up a time capsule, didn't it? Old school football, low scoring, close game. What a way to finish it up.
You loved it, didn't you?
I certainly did.
The defenses.
I certainly did. Brought back the images of the game of old.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Cleveland.
Right. Couldn't hit if you had iron. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost all the shine. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love cause I be loving. They ain't like my shirt, it's a large. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got two cribs and two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't.
Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. The type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank. Bye.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Tropicana go yard bandana. Big, big, a lot of like Santa. Threw a birthday party in a phantom. Big, big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, shining like acrylic. Yeah, yeah, I had cornrow. I can see you hanging with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my sparkle got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Bank account on some tall. Attitude on some. Bankroll on what it do, boo. He had to rule at five. And if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. The type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, bank. Big bank, tight, low bank.
She said, what you gon' do if I leave? I said, I'ma do me. B-I-G, everything zoomed in. Big, big on me looking like I'm moving in. Got my foot in the door and we still here. I'm a first generation millionaire. I broke the curse of my family not having. I'm passionate like just after more than just cashing. Feed me to the wolves, now I lead the packing. You boys all cap, I'm more Colin Kaepernick. I'm rare as affordable healthcare. Or going to wealth from welfare. I turn my W.
From the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Arrowhead Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They're set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the Minnesota Vikings. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. They run it here. Where? And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Tackle made there by the UCF man, Mike Hughes.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Now Mahomes throwing on second down. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time, and it's third down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. To throw, it's Mahomes. And this is caught by Watkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 47. They go play fake. Mahomes. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And again, it's Mahomes. Looking again for Watkins, and this time that's complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A gain of 32 that time. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Snap coming at one, and it's Mahomes. This is called Watkins, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Mahomes to the former Ram, Sammy Watkins, for the Kansas City first.
Well, I know from past experience, before you actually play a game, you visualize what's going to happen. And I don't know anyone who doesn't visualize themselves being in the center of what's going on. That's three catches for him here in the early going. He's got to like the way this is starting.
Absolutely. Three catches on any drive is good. Opening drive, that's a tone setter.
Left.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Spencer Ware taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive. The extra point up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. But Baker now to kick this one away. On the return, here comes Amir Abdullah. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 27. Now a play fake here on first down. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Justin Houston in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about 8.
And so much for that great field position to start the game. Now they're way behind the sticks. Can't wait to see what their second down call is going to look like now.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Throw, Cousins. And he's got the hook up here. It's Kyle Rudolph. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one goes for 24 yards. Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one good for 33 and a first.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. The All-Pro Justin Houston in on the tackle.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and they're going to have a third down. And he's able to find Diggs. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll run with Cook. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A great effort there. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game. Bailey now to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Chiefs as their offense makes their way back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35.
Four down.
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he'll work his way inside the 30 now to the 28. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a...
Mahomes to throw on second down. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Everson Griffin in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. Gonna need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. Throwing now is Mahomes. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Counter. Here's Williams. He takes us down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle, and that's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
Accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5.
Down, and that catch also puts him at 150 yards receiving now for the game.
Williams, and this will result in him losing yardage back to the 3. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
That's a really alert defense there, because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big time play for their defense.
And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a 3rd and goal. Can this Vikings D hold up one more time? 3rd and goal. Now they'll run it on the toss. He'll give up 6 yards there on the loss, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Brandon, I believe that they were in 4-down territory, and that's what they were thinking. But after the loss, I've got to kick the field goal. No way I'm going to go for it in this situation. But you know, some of these coaches, they're extremely unpredictable, and they may go ahead and press it.
Z. Slow.
Mahomes going to go on fourth down. And that is going to be incomplete. A disappointing drop there on fourth and goal. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he'll find some room to get this up to about the 14. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Second down, Cousins. And a hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Throwing, Cousins, and he's taken down, back at his own seven. Here's Matt Wild now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. A minute 59 to go in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. The Chiefs in good position to start out as they come up first and 10. Now Mahomes. He's going to air one out. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss him? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. He got 29 yards that time.
I know we just saw a nice throw and catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
They go play action here on first down. On the move to his left. That's going to be caught. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. 23 yards on the play.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, it was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. On the ground, this is Ware. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Spencer Ware with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is up to 8. Butker now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Vikings now heading on to the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully.
He's got a man complete. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. A huge play there. Cousins to his tight end Rudolph. 51 yards. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. First down, here's the run with Cook. He's to the 10. And did he get in? No, down at the 1 yard line. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. Well, he's broken off some big time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, you're confident.
And he will take this one into the end zone for a Viking touchdown. A great play there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings are within a 2-point conversion of tie in this game. This time, the extra point up and good. And the lead is cut to 1 at 14-13. Bailey now to kick this one away. This will be taken very short. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. This is caught inside the 15. And mark him down all the way inside the Minnesota 10. A big play there just before halftime. 63 yards. Well, that didn't take long. One play, and we're already looking at a first and goal situation. Now they try the right side here. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Mahomes now to throw. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. No move for the field goal unit. They're going to go here with 5 seconds left. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Spencer Ware in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead is up to 8. Now to kick this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
Here we go. Hey, Flipper, Flipper!
Cousins now on second down. Open here, Adam Thielen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That his first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there. They pitch it out to Cook. And a juke this time. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 46. Again, it's Cook. He takes this for about six down inside the 40.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Now a second down throw for Cousins. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. Justin Houston in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Cousins now from the 50. Open man is Thielen, it's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. To throw is Cousins. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. Anthony Hitchens. Leading the surge there, he drops him for a loss of six. Cousins with work to do after the sack as he brings his guys up on a third and long.
Yellow, 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 yellow.
Throwing is Cousins. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. A great effort there. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are within a 2-point conversion of tie in this game. Mike Zimmer's made the decision. His guys will go for two. Cousins now. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Bailey now to kick this one away.
Hey,
This will be fielded at the 8. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number 2. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at the 31-yard line. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. On second down, here's Mahomes. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sherman. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
From midfield, here's Mahomes. Blitz coming and down he goes. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sad.
Quarterback gets hit.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. On play action, it's Mahomes. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be third and a mile.
Ready. Blue 45. Blue 45.
Snap coming at 1, and it's Mahomes. He's going to go deep for Conley. It's caught inside the 25. A big play on third down for the Chiefs. And even 40 yards.
And that's how you throw for a whole heap of yards in a game. You get efforts like that from your receivers. How about him laying out for that catch?
Yeah, excellent. Makes a quarterback look a whole lot better. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
Black 58 rail.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. To throw, it's Mahomes. This is caught. Watkins. A good pickup there. 26 yards.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
We're back now in KC. It's been a good one so far. Just a 2-point game here as we get set for quarter number 4. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Working from the gun, Mahomes dancing to his left. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Second and goal from inside the five. They come up in an offset eye. He's going to get it running right. And he'll get this one back to the 5 yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? They come out here in the eye.
Blue 45. Left. Close.
Here's Mahomes, third and goal. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Anderson Dejo. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, this D, particularly the secondary, has been picked apart at points here tonight. They finally, though, get to the quarterback, get a pick.
And we know this about him. He loves night games, loves the spotlight, loves being the center of attention. I will bet you that he ran off the field almost chuckling to himself. They finally got one. They finally got me.
Following the interception, Cousins, middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he'll get this up to the four right about there, and that's about it. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
That first down completion only netted him three, second and seven. Back near the goal line, Cousins. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked by Kendall Thorpe, and he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a KC touchdown.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys were picking it off. They're not saying that. What word are they using? It's Oski. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
No problem there on the extra point. And that makes this a 9-point game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Now Abdullah, the return. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. And now out comes Minnesota. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at the 34. Back to it after the pick six. Cousins throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It'll be a gain of four, and it'll be a second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. Under four to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down.
Gun.
To throw, Cousins. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Eric Murray that time there to knock it away.
In most pass defenses, the guy playing safety has the ability to roam free and try and go to the football. But when you're a man, you've got to cover just like a guy playing out on the corner. Lock up on the receiver and go to the football. That's exactly what he did, batting that one away.
Hey, Clifford.
on third down. Cousins over the middle, complete. It's Morgan. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. Cousins to throw it. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. D. Ford. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Second down, Cousins. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Morgan. And he gets it down to the 32. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. Here's Cousins. And he's able to find Diggs. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A Vikings first down. Diggs able to find his way free and get the catch from Cousins. On first and 10, Cousins. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. On second down, Cousins again. Now he's got it. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
They get it to him running left. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. A great play there. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings are able to make this a close game again.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They had the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-to-5-play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-to-5-play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
Yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Hey, slow down. Shift.
Here we go. Blue 45.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. Another running situation on the doorstep as they come
Black
up second and 10.
Black 58 rail.
Mahomes going to throw it here. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle, that evens things out, especially for a road team, especially for a team that's an underdog.
Now here's Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. This is caught inside the 15. And mark him down all the way inside the Minnesota 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away.
Left, 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 left. Here we go.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And now the Vikings are going to stop it here on defense with a timeout, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal.
Here we go.
They get it to him running left. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. Another timeout called by the Vikings now, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down.
Black 58 rail! Black 58 rail! Ready! Blue 45! Blue 45!
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And Butker able to put this one through. And that will double their lead as it's up to 6. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, they're a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now, because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now out comes Minnesota. They're down here in a 1-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Just short of the 45 at the 44. Cousins to his tight end Rudolph for a Viking first down. Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. D Ford in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Over the middle here to Rudolph. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And the spike comes with 9 seconds left to go. There as it's intercepted, picked by Kendall Fuller.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw, and it'll wind up being intercepted.
Interesting, Mahomes wants to throw it. And going deep for Hill. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete.
seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life in the can't stop. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phone, they can hear us.
When you got dumb cake up in the say that they be waiting for you in the bushes with the duct tape. Up and down the interstate. Yeah, we really touch. We touch.